What does it mean? So let's do the one with the scale factor less than one. So let's say the scale factor is half this time around, 2, 5. If it's half, it's less than one, right? So what do you have? Half of 2 is what? It's 1. Half of 5 is what? 2.5. There's a reduction. There's a reduction. And that is a typical example of this one. If this happens to be the image, the A1, B1, D1, C1 is the image of ABC. It means it has reduced from the original, which is the bigger shape, to the smaller shape. Therefore, it's a reduction. So though we are talking about enlargement, right? There are two types of enlargement: increase enlargement and a reduction enlargement. Are you okay? Good. It happens by looking at what is the scale factor. So if a scale factor is greater than one, you get an increased enlargement. But if the scale factor is less than one, you get a reduction enlargement or a decrease enlargement. Then, if the scale factor is equal to one, I'm asking you, give me an answer. WhatsApp me and give me the answer. If the scale factor is equal to one, what happens? WhatsApp me and give me an answer. What if the scale factor is equal to zero? So give me a feedback on that. I'll be expecting your WhatsApp message. Good. So now let's see the next thing to do. Let's see if you can answer some few questions, right? You see how the examiners frame the question another. But before that, let's look at similarities. Similarities. Good. Similarities. At what point do we say two or more objects are similar in mathematics? They are similar, right? When they are similar, they are not the same. Take note. They are similar, right? When they have equal scale factors, they have something in common. The scale factors of each of the sides is the same. What do I mean by that? This is height. Here too, when you come here, this is also what? Height. So height against what? Height. This is hypotenuse. So hypotenuse against what? Hypotenuse. This is what? Base against base. Now, when you are calculating the scale factor, when you pick the image of the height, you divide by the image of the object. The corresponding side of it. So I can't take height over hypotenuse. It's a wrong comparison. You know, fraction is comparison, just like proportion, right? Or ratio. If I take base of the image, I'm going to divide by base of the object. You understand? Not hypotenuse, not height. So the same side over the same side, but it is image over object, which we have learned already. So let's use this as example. I'm taking the smaller one as my image. Did you get me? I'm taking this one as an image. When the examiner does not see which one is image, which or object, either of them you use, you get the same answer. The answer will not change. You get the same answer. But when he specifies that maybe DEF is the image of ABC, that means he said DEF is the image. Take it as the image and divide by the object, the smaller one. But I'm taking the smaller one. That's ABC as my what? Image. So if I want to calculate the scale factor of the height, it is scale factor. So let me use scale factor one. Scale factor, first scale factor is equal to what? The image over corresponding object, which is what? 9. So it should be 3/9. Height over height. Do you get it? What is the answer? 1/3. That's it. Let me do the other one. K2. Now I'm going to the base. This is the image. So K2, image over object. 4 will divide here 1 and divide here 3. K3 equal to, I'm going to the hypotenuse now. So 2. 2/6 give me 1. Here's 3. Therefore, triangles or shapes ABC and DEF are similar. This is the only way you can tell they are similar. Have you gotten the picture? So if they ask you which of the following are similar shapes, the job you are supposed to do is to test their skill factors. Therefore, if I have any work, I can say skill factor of height is equal to skill factor of hypotenuse, or skill factor of hypotenuse equal to skill factor of what? Base. And that will help me get if one side is missing. So if one side of any shape is missing, and they give you two shapes, and they tell you similar, or you can see from the drawing that they are similar, what you have to do is that equate the skill factor of the one known, the side known. You answer question, so you see how it works. To the skill factor of the side you are looking for. Just go. The rest is cross multiplication. There you go. So what do I mean by that? I can say the skill factor of the height is what? 3/9 is equal to 4/12. That's the side. That's all. So assuming this is missing, I don't know this. So I represent by x. Cross multiplication. So I get what? This gives me what? 3x. This will multiply that. So 3x equal to what? 4 times 9. Then I solve it here by 3. Here by 3. Then x equal to 3 cancel 3. 3, 4, 12. I get my 12, which was there already. You get the picture. So this is how it works. So simple. Very, very, very simple. Are you okay? So you create the scale factor of the known side to the scale factor of the side you are looking for, and the answer will come. As you solve more past questions, you see how beautiful it is to work scale factor questions. All right. So let's move on now. Okay, so looking at this shape, there are two triangles inside, right? And they are similar. So if you have to solve this question, the examiner has not given you which one is image and which one object. If it's not stated here, good. I think it's not stated here. So I pick the one I choose as my image. Now, what are the two triangles? First triangle, this one is one. APQ is a triangle, yes. Then ABC, the full one, is also another triangle. Do you see that? Thank you. So if I want scale factor, whose side will help me? Is it a base? Check the base. Base over base. This is 8, but this is not known, so I can't get scale factor. So I can represent here by what? X, if I want it. Can I use this side? AC is 6, so the full one, it's what, 6, but the image is not known. This must be known. From here to here must be known. It's not known. So I cannot use this. I can represent it by what? Y. You understand? But look at this side, AB, side AB. A to B is 5+2. Yes. We are giving them separate length. So you add them. So total was 7 centimeters. But he has given A to P. So the image and object is known. So let me pick the bigger one as image. It's an increase in enlargement. Bigger one as image. So if I want a scale factor of this, he asks for scale factor only. Just ask you to calculate scale factor. Scale factor K is equal to line AB, because I'm picking the bigger triangle as my image, over line what? AP, which is the short one. This one. It might be a triangle, triangle over triangle. So producing what would be my scale factor? K equals what? 7/2. That becomes my scale factor. So in case he asks for, let's say PQ, he asks for line PQ, right? Scale factor 7/2 might be equal to the scale factor of this. Simple. The scale factor of this side might be equal to the scale factor of this. My interest is this. So I equate it to this one, and then I get what? Scale factor. So what is the image over here? 8. What is the object? X. Cross multiply, I get my X. If he's asking for Y, he's asking for what? Y. That's line AQ. AQ. Scale factor, the same scale factor, is equal to what is the image at this side? AB, which is what? 6/AQ, which